dear colleagues at UMEME, it's important that I want to highlight to you some fundamental issues around the company over the recent past. You recall that this company was formed in 2005 as part of the privatization process where Uganda divested its distribution infrastructure to a private concessionaire, UMEME. And the fundamental objectives were to increase the number of connections on the grid, to improve on efficiencies, to improve on safety, and to bring in private capital to be invested in the distribution infrastructure. Over the last 11 years, all these have been achieved. And you as members of staff, as colleagues, have played a fundamental big part in the turnaround of this company to where it is at the moment. You'll agree with me that UMEME started off as a two-shareholder company between Eskom and Actis. And indeed, in 2012, the company was listed on the stock exchange, where we have over 5,500 private shareholders as owners of this company. It's also pleasurable to note that all the 1,400 employees were invited and offered 10,000 shares to play part in the ownership of the company. But to note that the company has achieved significant milestones over the last 11 years. On safety, we've reduced the amount of fatalities from over 18 per annum to now we've run for the last 2.5 years without any attributable fatality. Energy losses have been halved. We started at 38%. At the moment, they are running at around 19%. We are almost collecting 100% of our revenues billed compared to the 70% at the time the concession started. Over the last 3-4 years, we've doubled the value of the company with an EBITDA achieved last year of $76 million. We've more than tripled the customer base. We inherited 250,000 customers in 2005. At the moment, we've approached 900,000 customers, of which 60% of them are on prepaid metering. I'll not elaborate the achievements we have achieved in customer service. Our service levels have greatly improved. The survey done last year, we were scored at 70% compared to 43% customer satisfaction index that we achieved in 2011. So all these achievements, which are visible, which people applaud us of, which the government applaud us of, which our shareholders applaud us of, make us very strong and make us to be proud to be part of this family that is driving this agenda. However, I would like to bring to your attention some big threats that are affecting the company at the moment. And the fundamental one is the effects of power thefts and vandalism. Over the last 6 quarters, our level of energy losses has remained stagnant, running at an average of 19.5%. This year, our target was to achieve 17.1%. And if you look at our track record over the last 11 years, the company has achieved a sustainable reduction of an average of more than 2 percentage points per annum. This really is costing the country over 100 billion shillings through vandalism of the infrastructure, theft of transformers, theft of cables, theft of transformer oil, and notwithstanding the economic sabotage, our consumers cannot access power full-time to do their production. Our network is exposed. Any member of the public can die from the network. And the cost of restoring these breakdowns is quite significant. Notwithstanding the strain that is putting on our technical staff and operational staff to cope with the urgent need to restore supply to our consumers. Energy losses, 19.5%, is quite significant high. It's time we all stood up to be counted, call on our inert energy, and take action to reduce losses and attack the vandalism menace. Internally, we will provide you all the support that you require, be it capital infrastructure, be it operational materials, be it information, and be it security that may be required from the Uganda Police Force to deal with these economic crimes. What I call upon you is put in your body, put in your soul, put in your inert energy, and let's win this war against power theft and vandalism. We have done it before. I trust you, and I believe we can do it again and drive this company to greater heights. Thank you.